Hello and welcome to a new episode of Victoria 3 A to Z. Today, we're playing Brunswick. I'm starting to regret making this series. Now, I had no idea what to actually do with this country. So I made a poll and I let you choose. And you said I should go Agrarian. So let's start bolstering the rural folk. Let's also get some decrees. And just a couple taxes. For research, I don't even know what I should go for. I guess skirmish infantry. And I should probably create an army. Let's try to get 10 units. Let's get this rural folk general. And let's promote him. This will actually give more power to the rural folk. And I actually want to leave the British market. And damage relations with Hanover. Also get some rivals here in the north. And let's improve with the great powers. And I left the British market because I want to get some corn laws. That might be useful. We get a modern conservative. Let's make him the leader of the landowners. And let's bring the rural folk in government. And now we can go from tenant farmers to homesteading. And the landowners should not have any problem with that. Although yeah, we don't have that much support. But we got it anyway. Now let's go from mercantilism to protectionism. The rural folk really wants this. And the army is also slowly getting built. Popular playwright endorses reform. Best event in the game. That prestige made us a minor power. Okay, and we got skirmish infantry. But I'm not gonna switch to skirmish infantry just yet. That will cost way too much money. Now we can already kick the landowners out of government. Now we have 18 units. We can switch them to skirmish infantry. And Hanover only has 15. And they are line infantry. So I think this is a good moment to attack. If we're waiting too long, the economy will completely collapse. So it's now or never. And let's also get some enlistment efforts. That's an extra 3 units. Britain sides against us. But from what I can see, they're not sending any troops. So maybe we can do this. But now we're going into default, because we can't really sustain this army. But now we're actually able to push against them. And we got protectionism. But the question is, are we gonna beat them before we become bankrupt? And I don't really know. Okay, they are in the negatives. Everything is looking great. Okay, thank God they capitulated. That was a really tough war. Well, anyway, let's incorporate some of our new states. Now we're not going into default anymore, but we're still losing a lot of money. Well, the army is doing just fine, so let's attack some more people. And let's also get racial segregation. The rural folk wants that, for some reason. Let's also conquer Bremen, and let's also conquer Hamburg, before we become bankrupt again. German national identity. Prussia and Austria will go to war, and that war is also over. We managed to conquer this entire region. Now I only need to find a way to make the economy not collapse anymore. A racial segregation was also enacted. Now I want some dedicated police force. But Prussia and Austria are going to war now. I can't just focus on economy building and let this opportunity pass me by. I have to conquer some more countries. Oh no, Prussia joins against me. That's some horrible news. But maybe we can conquer some states from them as well. Especially here in the Rhineland. And I also want Brunswick. And also I'm taking Westphalia. And then I can try to liberate the rest of the Rhineland. I think that's more infamy efficient. Okay, this little country capitulated. And also the Russians are invading France. That's something you don't see every day. But the Prussians are now trying to push me back. And it's kind of working for them. Okay, they made peace with the Austrians. And looks like no one got German leadership. But that also means they are sending their entire army here. Which I'm not really a big fan of. So yeah, I think it's better if we just make peace with them right now. I will let them keep Brunswick, but I'm taking the Rhineland and I'm liberating Westphalia. Okay, that's better. But now the Prussians absolutely hate me for that. And we also have a ton of infamy. And now we have a dedicated police force. Now we could close the borders. I mean, that's what the rural folk wants. The borders are closed. No one can enter and no one can leave. And we also got rid of all that debt. Now I really want to get rid of the influence of the landowners. For that, I will form this government. And I will try to go from oligarchy to universal suffrage. This would probably cause a huge civil war, or we might actually be able to get this without a civil war, because the landowners and the industrialists don't want to work together. Just like I said, we actually got it, but our government is illegitimate. I guess we'll have to wait for the election, and I think I know who's gonna win. And we got railways unlocked, I guess we can build a couple. Okay, the agrarian party got absolutely all the votes, now that's pretty good. Now I guess we can go from interventionism to agrarianism. Let's give the rural folk all the power. Now my infamy has mostly gone away, so maybe it's time to attack the Rhineland. I will try to take over their entire country. Although they are pretty powerful. And agrarianism was enacted. Now I guess the rural folk wants consumption taxation, but I'm not gonna get it. I'll be losing way too much money. So I'm not gonna get any more laws for now. Meanwhile, the Rhineland is getting absolutely destroyed. And we can get a steel company. Now we can just annex the entirety of the Rhineland. That was a huge boost to our economy. Now the Prussians want to get the Ruhr back from us. That's not gonna happen. We are going to war. And I'll have to mobilize the entire country. The Russians are actually willing to help me. They want a treaty port in Prussia. Okay, we can have one in East Prussia. And that opens another huge front. Now, of course, I will also try to take some states from Prussia. And transfer me Hohenzollern. And Garibaldi came to our country. Okay, sure, you can stay. We occupied their capital, now it's just time to hold it. And the Russians just left. But that's fine, because we can enforce our war goals. There we go, the Prussians only have control over Prussia now. And now they are trying to get the German leadership. I don't really think it's a good moment for you. Oh, but they got French support. Okay, that's good. But Austria got Russia and Britain. This is basically a world war now. I really don't want to get involved in this. Instead, I'll do my own thing. attacking Mecklenburg. And they don't have anybody on the front line. Ooh, and I actually became a major power. Does that mean what I think it does? Yes, we are now a unification candidate. And we can get another company. Okay, now I want to get my infamy down and get some allies, maybe. And no one got the leadership in that war. Yeah, we have a pretty complicated situation. Now everybody wants Porlaus. Okay, I don't have a problem with that. A rural folk democrat. Okay, we can be the leader. And we got Porlaus. Now a big movement to get freedom of conscience has appeared. And yeah, I think I'll get freedom of conscience. The Netherlands is willing to bankroll us if we help them in a war in the Dutch East Indies. So yeah, sure, that's a really good deal. And we got freedom of conscience. Now we can also get elected bureaucrats. That was really fast. Now I was thinking maybe we can abolish the monarchy. As you can see, the petite bourgeoisie is led by a positivist. So let's get them in government and let's try to go for a parliamentary republic. I built up my army a bit more. And yeah, I think I'm ready to attack Prussia. I will take the leadership. But as you can see, if I click this button, I'll have to fight all the supporters of Prussia. So I don't really want that. So instead I'll declare war on Prussia for something else, like for example opening their market. And now we can just add the leadership as the war goal. And I don't have to fight a bunch of small German states. However, looks like I'll have to fight Sweden. But yeah, we're gonna win this war anyway. Okay, it's over for you. Getting the leadership from Prussia was really easy, because I've been bullying them the entire game. Austria, however, is gonna be a different story. For an obligation, we can get an alliance with France. Okay, that's definitely worth it. Okay, now I think I can beat Austria. So let's launch the leadership play. Russia sides with Austria, but I call in France. And I forgot I don't actually have a front line with the Austrians. So I guess we'll have to call in Prussia. They are willing to join if they get Anhalt. Okay, sure. I guess we can have it. Let's beat up Austria. And this front is actually pretty poorly defended. And the French are having a revolt in Senegal. But if I offer support, they are willing to give me Senegal. So yeah, sure. And I also did a naval invasion in Istria, which seems to have worked pretty well. Vienna is now in my hands. Or the Prussian hands, actually. Anyway, it's occupied. And there we go, we can enforce our demands. Now we are the only unification candidate in Germany. That revolt in Senegal is over. Now we have Brunswick and Senegal. And if I resolve the Schleswig-Holstein question, I can form the North German Confederation. So that means it's time to go to war with Denmark. They don't have any allies. But I do. And they actually just backed down. Well, there we go. Now we'll become the North German Federation. Although some people refuse to join. Well, bad luck for them, because for those guys I have claims. Schleswig, you have to join the North German Federation whether you like it or not. Wait, what? The Netherlands are willing to become our protectorate? Sure. That's an amazing deal. And we became a parliamentary republic. However, we might get a civil war because everybody wants colonies now. But the rural folk don't want colonies. So I'm not gonna get this. Instead, I'm gonna go from professional army to national militia. Sounds like an amazing idea. And the capitalist revolt started. But thankfully, we can get foreign support. From France. And Britain wants a defensive pact. Sure. Let's also call them into the war for an obligation. So we have Britain and France against this huge revolt. No way, the British just abandoned me. Oh, but of course they keep the obligation. That's obvious. Man, those people. And we enacted national militia. Maybe it wasn't the best timing though. And we won the civil war. The Agrarian League rules supreme. And now we can also reduce the autonomy of the Netherlands. They're a puppet, remember? Yes, much better. Now the leader of the rural folk is a protectionist and he wants to get interventionism. We have to follow whatever the rural folk says. Let's make them really happy. We got it. Now there is a movement that wants public schools. And the rural folk don't have any problem with that. Now let's be real, Anhalt is never gonna like me. So we'll have to attack them. And now we have public schools. Now we just need to make Austria like us and we can form Germany. I guess we can get right of assembly now. We have 100 relations but they still don't want to join us. I guess they need more time. Right of assembly enacted. Now how about guaranteed liberties? And we got it. So I tried to recruit more generals, because I thought someone interesting would appear. And guess what, we managed to get a Luddite, which is actually quite popular. You need to do some really weird stuff in order for this guy to appear. But yeah, I would like to recruit him. And I would like to make him the leader of the rural folk. So for that, we need a rural folk out of government. And now we need to exile the leader. And because the general is really popular, he'll become the new leader. There we go, just like I said. So let's get him back in government. And he really wants industry banned. So it's time to do it. It's time to ban all heavy industry. But those guys might cause a civil war. And the moment they heard we have a plan to ban all industry, the Austrians decided they want to be part of this utopia. So now we can actually form Super Germany. Let's get more loyalists. Now I would say we're looking pretty nice. And now the US wants a defensive pact. Sure, why not? Although, yeah, the US is not as powerful as they seem like. They have been divided. But we need some allies, you know, just in case we get a civil war. As you can see, the French are having a huge civil war. And I'm gonna help them. But I would like a bankroll for that. Oh yeah, that's a lot of money. And now we officially banned industry. Welcome to the German economical suicide. That means we can't produce any ammunition, any engines, or steel. Yeah, our economy took a bit of a hit, but we can still recover. The French are funding this entire operation after all. Now I guess we can get propertied woman. Let's also help the British in their civil war. Again for a bankroll. We got propertied woman. And now we're finally at peace. And Luxembourg became free for some reason. That's not allowed. You have to join Germany. Now we can finally be at peace. Oh, and by the way, the name of the law, industry ban, is kind of misleading. Because you are not actually banning all industry. You are just banning heavy industry. Stuff like munition plants, steel mills, motor industry, and whatever else you see on the screen right now. And it also disallows a couple automation methods. Sphere is not actually that bad, but we have to rely on a lot of imports. The intelligentsia now wants total separation. Okay, I think I can do it. We got it. And we got 1 million GDP. Now I'm getting bored, I want to attack someone. I think I'll go for the Ottomans, they seem pretty weak. Let's attack them to liberate Bulgaria. And now we got trench infantry. I guess we can switch to it. Although it will probably cost a lot of money. Okay, they just backed down actually. Then I'll go for Russia. I'm gonna liberate Ukraine. And the French really want to humiliate them. Okay, sure. And I also want to liberate Poland. And Belarus. Brazil and Italy side against me. Okay then. I'm taking Lombardy from you. Okay, Spain also joins. Yeah, the French are gonna have a pretty bad time. Oh, but I will not. At least Spain left the war. Lombardy acquired. Now only Russia is left. But I also took the Russian capital. So it's time to end the war. Yeah, that's better. I'm starting to regret releasing Poland. Now it's time for another war against the Ottomans. This time I'm taking Bosnia. And I'm also liberating Syria and Iraq. This time they want to fight. Time for the crusade, I guess. Let's end this. Yeah, now I feel better knowing I destroyed the Ottoman Empire. Now we gotta get rid of Poland because they're giving us bad events. Actually, they backed down, they became our protectorate. Now let's annex the Netherlands. Oh yeah, I think I've seen this one before. The Dutch are not allowed to exist. And I noticed we can form Central Europe. Let's do it, why not? A glorious union. And now we are called the United States of Europe. I'm not gonna lie, I like Germany better. Now in case you're wondering what happened to the rest of the world. Africa is still getting colonized, it doesn't look that bad right now. North America is looking pretty unusual. I mean the US got split in two, so they didn't really do much. So Mexico remained pretty powerful. South America is looking normal. The Qing didn't collapse this time around. However, Indonesia did. After we made the Netherlands our puppet, the East Indies became free. So now we have all of this mess. But anyway, let's go back to us. We are number 3 in terms of prestige, the French had a really good game, and although we have industry banned, we still managed to become the number 1 economy in the entire world by far, and we're also number 3 in terms of population, just below China and India. We actually did really well considering we have industry banned and closed borders. We did not play this optimal at all, but that just goes to show you how overpowered Germany actually is. Well, in the end, those are all my laws, those are my institutions, and those are my companies. So that's it, thank you very much for watching, I hope you enjoyed this video. If you did, don't forget to leave a like, subscribe to the channel for more Victoria 3 A to Z, and I'll see you in the next one.